That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Good morning, Eagles. It is Monday, January 8th.
My pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is mostly cloudy, 46 degrees and 10% chance of rain. On Tuesday, it's going to be light rain, 48 degrees, 70% chance of rain. On Wednesday, it's going to be a little bit rainy, a little bit snowy, 39 degrees and 80% precipitation. On Thursday, it's going to be mostly sunny, 39 degrees and 10% rain. And on Friday, it's going to be sunny, 43 degrees, and 10% chance of rain.
I read the Diary of a Wimpy Kid series. I like this series because Greg is always getting in trouble for what Roderick does, and Roderick is always getting in trouble for what Greg does. However, they both get in trouble for what Manny does. In book 12, they go on a vacation to the Bahamas, which is where their parents went on a honeymoon when they got married. You should definitely read these books if you like comedies and true events.
I read two book series. One was The Lemonade War, and it's about two siblings, Jesse and Evan. They had a lemonade war in the summer to see who could sell the most lemonade. It was a competition to see who could make the most money. If Jesse made the most money, she would donate it to an orphanage. If Evan made the most money, he would buy an iPod. You'll have to read these books to see who wins. I also read The Spiderwick Chronicles. I like this series because in one of the books, they fight a monster named Mulgrave. Mulgrave takes one of the silver rings and puts her in a coffin with a dress up. You'll need to read these books to see if she makes it out of the coffin.
Hello, Neil Armstrong. I'm here to introduce you to something new. You guys have all heard of Moonbucks, and we hope these are being handed out to classes all over the school for fabulous behavior as a class, as a group. They are what earns you class parties here at Neil Armstrong, and it's a wonderful thing. Now, drum roll please, big awesome music. Can you hear it? I think I can. We want to introduce the Supermoon. Supermoon is a double-sized moon buck, and these are going to be used for a few things. One thing that they are already being used for is for classes that have the best attendance in each grade. They're being sent out by Mrs. Anderson every week to those classes. So way to go to those classes. We have also been using them here and there in places that the faculty and Mr. Goebel feel like need them. And the one that we've been using them so far for is for the silverware and trays in the lunchroom. We're just supporting Mr. Robinson with them. And there may be some other places that the Supermoons come up, but that's it so far. Those are the ways that you can earn them: in the lunchroom by not throwing away your trays and your silverware, and by being here at school every day. Thanks for being here. Thanks for being clean and neat and respectful. Welcome the Supermoon.
Hello, ABC News. I am Ashton. Today I am interviewing Mrs. Olson. So, what university did you attend, and what extracurriculars did you do?
I went to the University of Utah, so I'm a Ute, go Utes. And I love to go skiing and hiking, so that's what I did. But first I went to Westminster for a couple of years, where I was the ski club vice president, and we went on a trip to, where'd we go, Jackson. So we skied there a couple of years.
That was very interesting. Tell us about your family.
My lovely husband Nick and my son Zach are my family, and then I have two very furry and friendly dogs, Ozzy and Angus. My son lives in Logan now because he's older, you know, because I'm a little older. And that's my family.
You have a pretty big family. If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go and why?
I would love to visit Australia because they have the best sport in the world. It's Australian rules football. And it's kind of a mix of soccer and football and rugby. But it's wild. It's on a huge field, and it's a very exciting game. And I watched it on television. I would love to go to a live game. So, yeah.
What do you like to do when you aren't at school?
I like to hike, and so I go hiking most of the summer. I'd spend hiking, and then I also love to go to the library. I go there every Saturday and check out lots of books and try to read every spare minute that I can. So,
reading is a very important thing in child's lives.
Yes, I agree.
I'm out. Bye. Thanks for watching. This was ABC News. Boop. Bwah.